Hello everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I want to talk about Star Wars and whether it's dead and buried or not. Okay, is Star Wars dead and buried? Well, if you take Lucas' support for Disney and Bob Iger into account, you sure could say it is. At least Star Wars as we know it, as we knew it from the good old days. But then it can of course be argued, what are the good old days? For many, it's the three OG movies, but for a lot, it's the prequel saga. And again, for others, it's the expanded universe and or all in between from the start till Disney bought it from Lucas. All right. Let's get the foremost and most obvious finding that lies at the origin of the assumption of Star Wars being regarded by many as dead and buried out of the way, namely Disney. Why Disney? Simple. Because they intertwine political messaging with their entertainment in a pretty extreme way. And they made it their main business model. So much so that it basically ruins all their films and makes watching them a very unpleasant experience. Disney owns Star Wars, and they have no intention to change their business model. That's why you can split up Star Wars in two periods, namely pre-Disney Star Wars and Disney Star Wars. And that when many say they consider Star Wars, as they knew it, from the so-called good old days, dead and buried, they mean pre-Disney Star Wars. This is predominantly because they know Disney's main business model is to intertwine political messaging with their entertainment in a pretty extreme way, and that they have no intention whatsoever to change their business model. However, it's not the only reason, the now main reason. Because you see, where Star Wars was by many already long regarded as dead and buried, it only recently was dealt the ultimate five-finger death punch death blow by none other than its own creator, its own spiritual father, Lucas himself. The one man that stood against Disney from the moment he realized he was betrayed by them. How did they betray him? Well, by not respecting his last wish of keeping to their mutual agreement to follow his storylines for Star Wars, as well as by using it as a means for political messaging. Lucas called Disney even white slavers for it. That's why many, many more than there were already since Disney bought Star Wars, now consider Star Wars as they knew it from the good old days, pre-Disney, completely dead and buried, because its own creator, its own spiritual father, Lucas himself, dealt his own brainchild the ultimate five-finger death punch death blow by some way, somehow, why is anyone's guess, rolling over for Disney and backing up Disney and Bob Iger. R.I.P. Star Wars? Well, yes and no. While Disney Star Wars may be screwed over and will continue to be foobarred, let's not forget there is still pre-Disney Star Wars, grained in all of our collective memories, as well as pop culture, forever. Anyway, this is my take on the matter. Do you have a take, or don't you care? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you, and until next time.